Now, before I embarked on this race, I was a single mum with two children. One was at university, and the other one was going up to university as I sailed into Boston. Now, that was a bit of a challenge. Now, the yachts are one design, and the crew is made up of one professional skipper and 15 core crew, of whom four are women. And we're the ones that go the whole way around the world. Whoever sponsors the yacht can put two people on for each leg of the race because they're learning leadership, man management, and development skills. Well, we were put into our cruise in January 2000, and our skipper had got nearly 9 months to hone us into a mean racing team. How is he going to do that? Well, he took us down to RAF Yeovilton, where the helicopter crews learn what to do when they ditch in the ocean. I hadn't shared something with the rest of the crew. I'm scared of the water. When I go swimming, this face doesn't go in the water, and if it does, these eyes stay very firmly closed. The basis of any relationship, whether it's in your personal life, in the sports arena, in the business environment, or you're off on an expedition, you have got to be able to trust your colleagues. Well, 10th of September came, start day. We were mentally and physically prepared. We'd been told to organize our wills. That was a bit scary. The yacht was prepared. And on the Sunday morning, we took a very fond farewell to our friends and family. We had 5,000 boats milling around, wanting to see us off and wishing us well. And we had decided before we set off that we wanted to end up in the top six. Number one is in there somewhere. I'm just a little bit competitive. What we hadn't done, though, was we hadn't put in a set of behaviors to achieve our objective. We arrived in Boston in 9th position. That wasn't in our plan. But we were a stoic crew, and we said, OK, this is a steep learning curve. What we didn't do was we didn't review what we had done well and where we could improve. You know, if you ask the latest person to join your organization what that organization looks like, they'll tell you, because they're looking at it with fresh eyes. Now, the winning skipper, when he got his crew, he asked every single one of them for their CV. And on that, he wanted their skills, hobbies, and interests, as well as their goals for the race. He used their skills, hobbies, and interests to win the race. We didn't have a culture of help, respect, and listening. Well, once we were in Buenos Aires, our next leg was going to take us round the notorious Cape Horn. We were scared. The apprehension was showing in our face, but it wasn't addressed. We arrived in Wellington in 12th position. We'd missed the civic reception and we'd missed the welcome party. But we did have the strength to put up our hand and say, we've got a problem. We decided that we would take a leaf out of Shackleton's book. We would put a mastermind group around our skipper. Now, he was a brilliant sailor and he understood the boat perfectly. But he hadn't done much ocean racing. Well, one of the watch leaders had. So we put him with the skipper. The management skills of our skipper were not quite as honed as we would have liked them to have been. And the other watch leader was a managing director, and he was very good with people. So we put him with the skipper. The skipper was still the skipper. He still made the final decision, but he could make a more knowledgeable decision because he'd got the expertise around him. Well, we had been 9th into Boston, 12th into Buenos Aires, 12th into Wellington, did not sail into Sydney. We came into Cape Town in 5th position. A mastermind group is very, very powerful. Now, next leg was Cape Town to La Rochelle. We were going home. As we went across the Bay of Biscay, we were playing cat and mouse with the Yacht Veritas. It's the people that make the difference. Last leg. We're going home. It's not really 870 miles from La Rochelle to Southampton. They wanted us to go on a very convoluted route so that we all came up the Solent together. Well, we don't do that, do we? But as we came up the Solent, yachts were coming out of marinas and yacht havens and quays, and they were all cheering us and foghorns were going off because they knew what we had done. And we had to go past Cowes. And as we did, the Isle of Wight ferry came out. The Isle of Wight ferry stops for no one. But on this day, it did. And the captain put over the tannoy where we had been and what we had done. And everybody came out and cheered and clapped us. We crossed the finish line at 8:30 p.m. on the 30th of June. And it was only then that we realized how huge our achievement had been. We'd been cold, wet, hungry, exhausted. We'd suffered sleep deprivation. We'd been in the most dreadful conditions. You saw the video. We'd been involved in a horrendous crash. We had been becalmed, not good in a race. We'd even gone backwards, even worse in a race. You take a position at 7 o'clock in the morning and you work really hard to go forward. And at 7 o'clock the next day, you take another position to find you're behind where you started the day before. That's stress. That is frustration. But used correctly, it can help you achieve your goals.